Hi, Tom Lydon here in Chicago at the Morningstar Conference with legendary financial columnist Chuck Jaffe. Chuck, great seeing you.
Good to see you. Not necessarily legendary.
Yes, but, legendary.
Is that just an adjective that makes me old?
Well, part of the reason you're legendary is because you and I have been coming to this conference for decades,
yes.
Right? And we've seen a big change in trends. I mean, when we first came here, mutual funds were all the rage. Now we're seeing a lot of ETF companies. Talk about that transition.
Well, I mean, if you're an ETF investor, you didn't want to come to this conference in the past. This conference, I mean, Morningstar set up this conference, and then when ETFs evolved, they said, this will be the mutual fund conference, and we'll create ETF Invest, and that will be the ETF conference. Now, let's put it in investment terms. The difference between those two conferences was, where did alpha sit?
Yeah.
If you came to the Morningstar Investment Conference, this one that we're at now, and it was the mutual fund conference, you get the star fund manager on the stage, and that's where he was talking about, you know, what to buy, whatever. That's where the alpha was.
Yeah.
If you went to the ETF Invest Conference, the guys on the stage were the guys who were putting together products that you were trying to figure out how to use. If you were the audience member, you were the financial advisor who was making portfolios of ETFs. So you were the alpha in the audience. So you had this difference of alpha being on stage, let's go listen to a star fund manager, versus alpha being in the audience, let's go listen to what you can do that's going to help me understand how I better want to shape a portfolio.
Okay, and but look at the last 10 years. Passive has almost been the alpha because it's active management's had a tough time.
Well, yes, but again, you have to judge passive. Passive, you can have a passive fund, but you have managers and advisors who are actively managing passive funds. So it's passive investment, but it's actively passive. This is this whole thing that, you know, there's a diagram that you can put where you start on the active and the passive scale, and it's active and passive for your funds, and active and passive for you as a money manager, right?
Yeah.
So a Jack Bogle investor is passively passive. I buy an index fund, I hold an index fund,
I don't do nothing with it.
That's passively passive.
But your point is correct. We could talk about performance of actively managed funds or passive ETFs. What really matters is what's the net performance
for the
individual investor.
That's correct. And that's ultimately the thing that the individual investors don't see because they're not here, is this idea that says, wait, how am I going to want somebody to manage money? And where do I want the alpha to sit?
Yeah.
If I'm the kind of person who says I want to be a do-it-yourself investor, then I want to go hire that money manager, et cetera, or I want to hire somebody who's going to build me a portfolio of passive funds, but not manage it, be passively passive.
Yeah.
If I think that I can do better by factor investing, by doing a bunch of other things, then I want to be at least actively passive and have a manager who's going to move. And that's the irony of the public not being here, is that they're the ones who could benefit from sort of sitting in and going, oh, no, that's the guy that I want to run my money, or that's the style that I want.
Just because of their style, not necessarily the tools that
they use. That's correct.
Right. Excellent. Great little snippet there, Chuck. As always, my friend, good seeing you.
Always a pleasure, Tom.
Thanks.